The Lord be with you. Let's worship. A good prayer. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Welcome home. Find rest for our weariness. Welcome home. Welcome. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the God of manna, the God of miracles, the God of mercy.
Amen.
Drawn to Christ and seeking God's abundance, let us confess our sin. God, our provider, help us. It is hard to believe there is enough to share. We question your ways when they differ from the ways of the world in which we live. We turn to our own understanding rather than trusting in you. We take offense at your teachings and your ways. Turn us again to you. Where else can we turn? Share with us the words of eternal life, and feed us for life in the world. Amen. Beloved people of God, in Jesus, the manna from heaven, you are fed and nourished. By Jesus, the worker of miracles, there is always more than enough. Through Jesus, the bread of life, you are shown God's mercy. You are forgiven, and loved into abundant life.
Amen.
A gathering hymn, hymn 508, as Rain from the Clouds.
As rain from the clouds will your word come to earth, as snow from the heaven refreshing the land, then soften our soil that the good seed may grow and ripen rich fruit to return to
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Oh,
O God, you are the tree of life, offering shelter to all the world. Graft us into yourself and nurture our growth, that we may bear your truth and love to those in need. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. You may be seated for reading of Scripture.
The first lesson is from Ezekiel chapter 17. Thus says the Lord God, I myself will take a sprig from the lofty top of a cedar. I will set it out. I will break off a tender one from the topmost of its young twigs. I myself will plant it on a high and lofty mountain. On the mountain height of Israel, I will plant it in order that it may produce boughs and bear fruit and become a noble cedar. Under every kind of bird will live. In the shade of its branches will nest winged creatures of every kind. All the trees of the field shall know that I am the Lord. I bring low the high tree. I make high the low tree. I dry up the green tree and make the dry tree flourish. I, the Lord, have spoken. I will accomplish it. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
Psalm 92. It is a good thing to give thanks to the Lord, to sing praise to your name, O Most High.
To herald your love in the morning and your faithfulness at night.
On the psaltery and on the lyre and to the melody of the harp.
For you have made me glad by your acts, O Lord, and I shout for joy because of the works of your hands.
The righteous shall flourish like a palm tree and shall spread abroad like a cedar of Lebanon.
Those who are planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God.
They shall still bear fruit in old age. They shall be green and succulent.
That they may show how upright the Lord is, my rock, in which there is no injustice.
The second lesson is from 2 Corinthians chapter 5. So we are always confident, even though we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith, not by sight. Yes, we do have confidence, and we would rather be away from the body and at home with the Lord. So whether we are at home or away, we make it our aim to please him, for all of us must appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense for what has been done in the body, whether good or evil. Therefore, knowing the fear of the Lord, we try to persuade others. But we ourselves are well known to God, and I hope that we are also well known to your conscience. We are not commending ourselves to you again, but giving you an opportunity to boast about us, so that you may be able to answer those who boast in outward appearance and not in the heart. For if we are beside ourselves, it is for God. If we are in our right mind, it is for you. For the love of Christ urges us on, because we are convinced that one has died for all. Therefore, all have died. And he died for all, so that those who live might live in no longer for themselves, but for him who died and was raised for them. From now on, therefore, we regard no one from a human point of view. Even though we once knew Christ from a human point of view, we know him no longer in that way. So if anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
Holy Gospel according to Mark, the fourth chapter. Jesus said, "The kingdom of God is as if someone would scatter seed on the ground and would sleep and rise night and day, and the seed would sprout and grow, he does not know how. The earth produces of itself, first the stalk, then the head, then the full grain in the head. But when the grain is ripe, at once he goes in with his sickle, because the harvest has come." He also said, "With what can we compare the kingdom of God? Or what parable will we use for it? It is like a mustard seed, which when sown upon the ground is the smallest of all the seeds on earth. Yet when it is sown, it grows up and becomes the greatest of all shrubs, and puts forth large branches, so that the birds of the air can make nests in its shade." With many such parables, he spoke the word to them, as they were able to hear it. He did not speak to them except in parables, but he explained everything in private to his disciples. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
May be seated. Let's pray together. O Lord, may your word that comes to us this day take seed and roots. May our imaginations be quickened to see you all around, to be overcome, overwhelmed by your blessings which are everywhere, to spread those blessings everywhere we go. Open our eyes, O Lord, to see you and call us. To Jesus we pray. Amen.
Amen.
In our reading today in the Gospel, we have, look at all of the mustard seed up there, yellow fields. We have the reading of Jesus talking about throwing the seeds, planting the seeds, and we water the seeds, but we don't know how it grows. We can't make that happen. And it reminds me of Ed was telling me that he got these tomato seeds from Connie some years ago, and he was sure they were dead. So he planted them. He decided to plant a whole bunch in these groups instead of just one in each one, because he was sure most of them would not give root. But what do you know? They all gave root. And they all grew, and he had like 60 tomato plants that he was trying to find people for, and Laura took 40 of them, much to Jack's delight. And so Ed planted these seeds and watered them, and they just grew. And they grew all by themselves in an abundance that was more than what he imagined. So we read in the scriptures, this is, the rock has some Hebrew on it. And in Galilee, the fields, when I went, was living there, and we traveled in Galilee, the fields were just yellow with these wild mustard seeds that spread everywhere. You know, in the other Gospels, it talks about it as a tree. It's not really a tree. But you can see that some of these wild ones do grow pretty high. But what struck me was not how big they grew as far as how high from this little tiny seed, but the next slide, how it just, this is a field in Israel, how the mustard seed just spread and covered everything. And if you've ever seen the mustard seed, it's just, it's smaller than a Sesame Street. It's just like a little speck. And to think that that little seed can just spread and do this, it changes the landscape. Sometimes I think that we get caught up in law, and we think about Jesus saying, if you have faith like the seed of a mustard seed, you can say to this mountain, it will be moved. And we think, okay, we got to have faith. We got to have enough faith to do that. I think the point is not the size of our faith, but it's what God does with it. And the little seed absolutely changes the landscape. And the mustard seeds that God has brought in our lives have changed the landscape. This comes along with parables that are talking about the sower spreading seeds in all kinds of land. Land where there's birds that take up the seeds, land where there's briars and thorns, hard land, then that can't put in out its roots. And then fertile land that yields 100-fold What I was reading was 100-fold is a higher yield than what you would expect from seeds. But the stories that Jesus tells is the kingdom of God is like these small events that happen in our life that change the landscapes of our life. The first reading, by the way, it talks about taking a sprig from the highest point of this tree, that God does that. Wednesday night, we spent time talking about that text because that is a piece that follows after what precedes it. It talks about two eagles taking sprigs from the top of trees and planting them, and it's rooted in the politics and struggles of the northern kingdom with evil kings. We are reading that one of the kings was like 8 years old or 9 years old, and he ruled for 3 months, and he was evil. How about that? How much evil can you do in 3 months? And the king of Babylon removed him because he did not think this child was fit to be king of Israel. But you can go to the website and hear more about that story if you go back and review our Wednesday night service. Our service this morning will focus more on the gospel text. And think about, what are the little seeds that have come in your life that have changed the landscape of your life? These are my Tibetan boots. And there are Tibetan boots like these. It was a little seed. Just someone walked past me with a boot on like this and with all tied up with this. And that event changed my life. That was this little tiny mustard seed. And how many people have I changed? Passed by and not noticed what they're wearing. How many people's shoes did you notice today? But the person that was wearing this was in college, and no one told her that these weren't in style. And she had long, dark, black braid going part way down. This was in the 80s when people had this foopy hair blown back and stuff. And she's wearing an Indian jacket. And I thought, I got to get to know this person. And I married her. I married her. And it's all because of this little tiny seed the size of a mustard seed in the events of our lives that we don't even notice, so small we don't see those things, that I happened to notice, and it took root in my life, and it changed my life. And she has taken me to worlds I never imagined I would go to. Not only on the globe, but everywhere we are, she's opened my eyes up to see worlds through eyes that are different than my own. And my life is so much richer because I'm seeing things around me I never would have seen without her. That little mustard seed came and changed our lives with other little seeds. We are rejoicing today, a few days ago, 3 days ago, I think, Pastor Mark Molter and their wife, Kate, welcomed their second child into the world. Little Camille was born. And they sent pictures of her, and she's absolutely beautiful, peering with these new eyes, looking up at the camera. And I'm just wondering, what is she thinking? What is she experiencing? How does she make sense of this sense that she has never had before in her life or never made sense of? And so in our lives, we were changed by our four kids coming along. And we didn't always know they were going to come. In fact, one of them changed our lives, and when that person came, we ended up having the whole pastoral care department of the hospital at our house giving us oxygen, helping us breathe, because we were caught unaware of this pregnancy that was going to change us. And she's brought more laughter and delight into our lives. These events that we never maybe anticipated in that way. Events that change our lives. Another seed. Sometimes the seeds that we see, we know are good or are something that attracts us and draws us from the beginning. There's other seeds that maybe are not as welcome. Medical school, I was taking a class in physiology, and there was a test coming up, and I had to get a perfect score to pass the year. As soon as over the year you lose 30 points cumulative all throughout the year, of all your pop quizzes and exams, the day that you miss 30 points, you fail the year. When I began medical school, we had 80 kids in our class, and our teachers told us every day, if you're lucky, 20 of you will pass the year. And that was about what it was the first year. In the second year, I took that exam. Actually, I didn't take that exam. I was supposed to take the exam on a Monday morning. And my sister was getting married over the weekend, and I flew to where she was, enjoyed the wedding, and I told my dad, I just don't know about all of this. He says, go out and pray. And I didn't go back to medical school. And that was a seed, a little seed, that changed my life in incredible ways. That's why I get to be with you today and why I've been so blessed by you. And sometimes there are things that are disappointments. I just can't do this. I can't make this. And sometimes those become the turning points. They become the mustard seed that change the landscapes of our lives. And the life that I had plotted out for me didn't go very far away from the medical school where I was studying. But my life with the seeds that ended up in my life have taken me to places beyond my imagination. Another seed, I've told you about this, was on the way to bury my mother. We stopped at an intersection. I had my uncle, who was a juvenile court judge from Atlanta, Georgia, powerful man, sitting next to me. And there's a beggar that came up. I rolled my window down. My uncle said, roll up the windows, roll up the windows. Fear of this person and this coming over to the car, unannounced, unexpectedly. And I didn't have money. And I reached out my hand and I said, I don't have anything to give you. I'm on the way to bury my mom. And this beggar took my hand in both of his hands and began to bless me and give me strength for the journey of burying my mom. And that conversation at the intersection, I've never forgotten that. And to this day, that beggar is with me, giving me strength in all the times that have followed. That was a little mustard seed that changed the landscape for years to come. And whenever I am accompanying people who have a loved one die, those stories come back to me. The conversations, the last conversations I had with my mom and with my dad, with each of them before they died, are little grains of mustard seed that have changed the way I see life, the way I see heaven. One of the last conversations with my mom was she said, I have said everything I need to say. Have you said everything you need to say? And I said to her, I've said everything I need to say. I've also heard everything I need to hear. I think she needed to hear that her kids would be in heaven. And she needed to hear that. And she didn't hear that in those words, but I told her, I've heard everything I need to hear. And then when she died, it wasn't true anymore. I had tons of questions about what is that experience of death like? And pursuing that journey, that little mustard seed has taken away some of the fear of death for me. And I've come to see more of an adventure with that, that is waiting for all of us. Conversations with her about where is heaven, that changed my perspective. I think heaven is all around us. We just don't have the eyes to see it. Mustard seed, those conversations that have changed the landscape of my life and how I see things like life and death. I've told you this before too. I was running around with tons of things to do and I was going into a store in Delaware. And a woman, not close to me, you know, a little ways away in the parking lot, was walking by. She called out, good morning. And I said, good morning, how are you? And she said, too blessed to be stressed. I never saw her again, and I never forgot what she said. And when people ask me how I am, the line that comes into my mind is, I'm alive and I'm blessed. And it's just a little mustard seed that this woman planted, changing the way that I see things in life. When stress comes up, are we blessed? And now Jeff always greets me, too blessed to be stressed. Those little seeds that change our life, that change the landscape, that color our lives. So these are things that, it's what God does. That God can take these small events in our life and work for good for them. God can take tragedies and work for good. And I think about the mustard seeds that we encountered when we accompanied people following the earthquake, people who lost their homes, people who lost loved ones, people whose lives were changed dramatically in one day. And to accompany them and see miracles and changes come into their life. I don't think that they ever were happy that the destruction of that night happened. But God took that event and turned it around and used it for blessings in their lives, brought new family members into their lives, gave them new homes. And one of the things that struck me was David, who lost about 15 family members, was the first one to have his house surrounded by flower gardens. And the beauty of that, where he spread that beauty to everyone else. It's Father's Day, and we are blessed because we've had fathers. We are blessed because we have children. We are blessed because of families that God gives us. What else do I have behind you? I had to glue the soles back onto these shoes because they were coming off. But I haven't gotten rid of them. They fit my feet, they're comfortable. And these shoes have taken me to all kinds of places. These shoes have tromped around in the soil of the Amazon, Ecuador. These shoes took me through Nepal and through Kenya this last month. These shoes have taken me hiking through here, through these areas, old and battered. Do we need new shoes? But I keep them because they tell stories, and they're comfortable and wear. But these things are from seeds that were sown, and they tell the stories of the journeys of my life and the places I've gone, the things I've been able to do. This morning, Kathy came in, and she saw me, and she sang a little song after looking at me. Old age is golden, so I've heard, but sometimes I wonder as I crawl into bed. My ears are in the drawer, my teeth are in the cup, my eyes are on the table until I wake up. How do I know my youth is all spent? My get up and go has got up and went. But in spite of it all, I'm able to grin and think of the places my get up has been. She saw this lying on the table. She said, I thought about adding a verse saying my back and my leg is on the chair. Some of us are getting older. And some of those changes are things that we don't necessarily welcome. But those are stories, our acts, our pain, I think, are stories of all the tiny seeds in our past that have sown and the miles we've gone to. All the things we've heard with those ears that now are on the table. And with the eyes, the things we've seen, the experiences we've had. We are incredibly blessed. And this piece about the mustard seed is that this blessing comes not by our doing, but by God. And so I want to read one last song to you. And this song is one we listen to sometimes, Spanish music. And this one is Señora de las Cuatro Décadas. The title is Mrs. of Four Decades. Mrs. of Four Decades and footsteps of fire when you walk. Your figure no longer is the same as when you were 15. But time doesn't know how to fade your sensual touch and the volcanic power of your gaze. Misses of the four decades, let me discover what lies behind those silver threads and the abdominal grasa, fat, that aerobics just doesn't know how to get rid of. This is English translation, so it doesn't fit the song. Misses, and if you can hear this in Spanish, it's all to passionate singing. Misses, do not take years off your life. Add life to your years, which is better. Misses, do not take years off your life. Add life to your years, which is better. Because notice, when we hold each other, you are feeling the same ribs that you felt more than 20 years ago. Notice that you happen to be a perfect combination of experience and youth. Sometimes the aches and pains that we have, we long for our days of youth. Dr. Jack would be out of a job if we were all 20. But maybe the aches and the pains that we have are telling the stories. The aging that we go through is telling the stories of all the blessings that we've had throughout our lives. The back pain I had this week was telling the stories of all that my back has done. Jesus said, the kingdom of God is like a teeny tiny mustard seed, and God will take it and change your life. We are blessed incredibly. May God bless you on Father's Day.
Join me in reciting the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. Believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
You may be seated for prayer. O Lord our God, you are truly good. Even the things that are deep disappointments and tragedies in our lives, you work to bring beauty in life and hope. May we, O Lord, see the world and the events through your eyes. May we see the possibilities, the joys, the goodness, the beauty, the spreading of what you do. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, in the hurts and pains, the things that have happened this week may be for us. May we know that we belong to you, that we are in your hands, that nothing can remove us from your hands. And that's a good place for us to be. May we, O Lord, trust and look to you rather than external things that cannot sustain us. Lord, in your mercy. For the nations of this world, O Lord, for where people vie for power, where struggles are happening and innocents suffer. For the earth itself, O Lord, that is marred. We bring these things for your healing, and we thank you, O Lord, that you can take even the smallest events and work unexpectedly to spread blessing. Lord, in your mercy. We come to you, O Lord, with those who are dear to us, people on our prayer list. We thank you that you are a God at work, that you breathe life into us, that you are at work with healing every day. We come to you, O Lord, with John Hafer, Kara Fleming and little baby Miles, Bill and Mary Sue Crawford, Rosie and Becky McIntyre, Jack Zeeland, Carolyn Yammer, Barb Simmons, Shorty Smith and Jim, their anniversary, David Tibbetts and his family, Donna Yater, Joyce de Munbrun, Pam Mulligan, Faye Crawford, Marion Biddle, Robert Twin, Kathy Powell, Patty Wilson, Bert Leach, Mitzier and Jerry Robinette, Lise and Dave Ahern and their family, Mary Lou Rolls, Laura Murray, Anna Brooke, Sharon McKenzie, Leanne and Jason Leisure, Rick and April Realms, Gary Llewellyn and Val. Gary returned from traveling and has COVID. For others, O Lord, in their travels who have become ill. For Nancy Hauser, for Nayano, for Dalton, for Rosanna White, for Joyson, for Logan Perry, for Rayanne on her trip, for continued healing for Charlie Boone, for Dalton, for Ashley, for Rosanna, Lord, in your mercy. At this time, I'd like to ask Stephen to come up. Stephen will be going, having surgery this coming Tuesday?
Wednesday.
Wednesday, open heart surgery. So can we come up and those who are able and willing, lay hands on him and we'll pray for him. So in the next weeks, he's going to be resting and won't be back here. So that leaves our crew here with a hole and a mini vacation. There we go. Come on. You can come up here. Oh, Lord, our God, we thank you for life. We thank you for seeds that are sown. We thank you for those who stayed in medical school and didn't quit so that they can help Stephen at this time. We thank you for all that we have learned and the things we've been able to do, amazing things. So we pray for Steve and his family as he has on Wednesday this surgery that's coming up. We ask that you would be with the care providers, give them wisdom and skill, that you would, O Lord, care for what his needs are. For his family, O Lord, that you would watch over them in their travels, in their times of waiting, in times of recovery, in the times it just changes the everyday events for a while. We ask for your healing for Steve in the days following surgery, for strength and for your peace. He has blessed us so much in so many ways. And as I hear the sirens go off in our community every day, I think about Steve and his work answering calls of people as he rides in vehicles with those sirens running. Oh Lord, bless him in this time. Heal him and give him strength that he might continue to bless us and bless our community and bless his family. We thank you, O Lord, that you are the God who created us, raised us up, the God of healing and power, the God of peace and love and mercy, and that you go before us and shine the way where we can't see. We rest in you. Through Jesus we pray. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And also with you.
Thank you.
Jesus, bread of life, you have set this table with your very self and called us to the feast of plenty. Gather what has been sown among us and strengthen us in this meal. Make us to be what we receive here, your body for the life of the world. Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and all places give thanks and praise to you, almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with all the choirs of angels, the church on earth, and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Our Maker, Redeemer, and Healer, in the harmonious world of your creation, the plants and animals, the seas and stars were whole and well in your praise. When sin scarred the world, you sent your Son to seal our ills, to form us again into one. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me," the body of Christ broken for you. Again, after supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks and gave it to all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood. It's shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me," the blood of Christ shed for you. Remembering, therefore, his acts of healing, his body given up, his victory over death, we await that day when all the people of the earth will come to the river to enjoy the tree of life. Send your Spirit upon us in this meal. As grains scattered on the hillside become one bread, so let your church be gathered from the ends of the earth, that all may be fed with the bread of your life, your Son. Through him all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, both now and forever. Amen. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Christ has set the table with more than enough for all. Come. All are welcome to come and receive. As you come up, you can bring a cup with you. The empty ones we'll pour wine into. The other ones have grape juice. If you prefer grape juice, bring one that's already filled. And if you need gluten-free, the Lowells have gluten-free bread. This has gluten in it. All are welcome. Come and receive.
Oh,
Blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you and keep you in God's grace. Amen. Jesus, bread of life, we've received from your table more than we could ever ask. As you've nourished us in this meal, now strengthen us to love the world with your own life. In your name we pray. In this coming week, as you experience perhaps pains or signs of your many experiences in life, may you know that in God's sight, you are beautiful and loved. The blessing of God who provides for us, feeds us, and journeys with us be upon you now and forever.
Amen.
Our hymn 547, Sent Forth by God's Blessings.
Supper is ended, oh, now be ended.
Go in peace. You are the body of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Hello.